Let's move forward and let's talk to the Blue Dart management. We've got on board with us Aneel Gambhir. He's the CFO at Blue Dart. Aneel, hi, morning. It's been another weak quarter on all counts for you. What surprised us most is that profits have halved on a year-on-year basis. What, according to you, has led to this?
Good morning. Firstly, let me tell you that this first quarter, which results have been announced yesterday, the results which have been announced yesterday, basically if you look at it, the profits are down in this quarter as you mentioned. This result, key reason for that is that post festive season last year, in as an industry were looking for, you know, growth, better growth from B2C market. However, for that, to handle that growth, all players had generated capacity in the system so that they can handle the volume. However, in November 2016, when demonetization happened, the volumes got impacted. As a result, everybody was sitting with the excess capacity, and though after demonetization impact, which is over a period of time, had got reduced, the volumes started coming in. But then because the surplus capacity which was generated is still to be used fully, so as a result, our volumes are impacted. If you look at it, all retailers have their own in-house logistics capacity. So they had also had capacity generated to handle volume. But because this volumes got impacted, first preference they are giving to their own in-house logistic companies. So as a result, three PL players are not getting the volume which were expected, and which has got impact on our top line and our bottom line.
Mr. Gambhir, this is your first time on ET Now, so very warm welcome once again. Thank you for joining us. Can you also quantify for me the growth in your e-commerce business?
Our e-commerce growth is in our top three verticals. If you look at it, so very significant for us in terms of top line growth.
Are you getting a sense that the e-commerce business now may not be able to grow at a historical growth rate? And, you know, please appreciate my curiosity, which is around your e-commerce business, because a couple of years ago when the e-commerce business started, all of us were very excited about the fact that our logistics companies would monetize this entire e-commerce boom.
I guess growth would come back, may not come back at the same rate what was happening earlier. Reason being, one, that earlier the base was lower, so obviously now with the base increasing, the growth percentage would come down. But having said that, GST would play its role, because earlier each state had their own entry restrictions. Like if you talk about UP, MP, Kerala, where there were a lot of forms required, and e-commerce companies were not able to provide those forms because of supplies from every corner of the country. Now with the GST coming in, where forms will go away, we expect that there's a healthy growth in e-commerce space as well.
Okay. Can you also quantify for us that how exactly GST implementation will benefit you? Because GST implementation is good news for logistics companies. That's the broader headline. But what we also know is that now the dependence on truck companies, the dependence or the over-dependence on logistics companies will only reduce. So whereas on one side, the entire goods transaction will be easy, but do you think from a GST standpoint, first there are going to be hiccups before you start monetizing it?
See, as we are reading in media, and even ministries are also saying that the GST is going to be good for industry. And of course, when it's good for industry, obviously logistics will also get benefit of it. And as media reports are also saying, and transport ministry also has been talking about, that efficiency in transportation would happen because of various initiatives taken by government. Obviously, that will have a good play for logistic players as well. So we expect that benefit to come in a longer run. However, it's too early to talk about those benefits at this stage, because we just started our journey on GST.
Okay, good to hear that. Thanks so much for taking the time out then, Mr. Gambhir, and highlighting really how the quarter has been. Good luck for the future quarters ahead, and I'm sure we'll chat soon. That's the word coming in from the Blue Dart management. Blue Dart, the stock is currently